What's going on, everyone? Rob back with another video, and this is one that I was not expecting to do anytime soon. But as you can see, we have got ourselves the new DualSense controller for the PS5. This arrived at my door on Monday, and yeah, let's take a look at what's inside the box. But first, let's take a look around the box. So as you can see, this is the DualSense controller. This is the all-new controller for the PlayStation 5, and I'm really, really excited. Amazon has begun sending out the accessories if you pre-order them via their website, as well as some people have mentioned that these are actually on store shelves at the moment. So if you walk into Best Buy, if you walk into GameStop, you might actually see these on the shelf, as well as the universal, the remote, the media remote. I'm not sure about the Pulse headphones. I know some people were looking into the Pulse, but yeah, this magically got charged on my card on Amazon over the weekend and pretty much arrived in 2 days. So the back of the box pretty much shows all the features of the new controller. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a PS5 with me because of the launch, and I can't really test out all of the features, actually any of the features. So this is going to be sort of like a first impression unboxing of it. And yeah, let's take a look. So it says haptic feedback, feel more with physically responsive feedback to your in-game action. So pretty much it's going to react based off of the inside, you know, when you're playing with the controller, the game is going to rumble and it's going to give you that feedback back on the controller. Adaptive triggers is something that I'm excited about. Experience varying force and tension when interacting with your in-game gear and environment. So the triggers are going to respond with whatever is happening in the game. So if the game doesn't want you to press down on the triggers will actually lock, from what I've heard. I'm not too sure about that. We're going to be testing that later on once we have the PS5 in-house. Built-in microphone to chat online with friends. It actually has a built-in mic into the controller with a little speaker as well. So you can, you know, you don't need a headset or whatnot. You can kind of just use the controller as is. And signature comfort. Enjoy an intuitive design with featuring enhanced sticks and touchpad. All right. So let's go ahead and just take a look. It's pretty straightforward, to be honest. There's not much in here. Let's go ahead and see what we can pull out. We just dropped something. Let's go ahead and put that back here. Let's put it right there. And let's see. It's just this white box here. Yep, so it's pretty straightforward. It doesn't look like it comes with any charging cables or anything like that. We do get is this a manual? This is a wireless controller instruction manual, which we won't use. And then here it is, guys. This is the DualSense. Now, I am an Xbox gamer. It's been a very, very long time since I used a PlayStation control. So I'm extremely excited to get my hands on this. I have used the DualShock 4 and the DualShock 3. I have used them, but have I owned them? No. So familiarity, I hope I said it right, with the controllers is very, wow. Like, it's literally, it stopped me from talking because this controller feels absolutely amazing. I was never that much of a fan of the DualShock controller, and this one just honestly feels similar to the Xbox controller. I do love that the actual handles are shorter. You can take a look on here. They are shorter. I mean, oh, sorry, longer. They are longer. You can see the top on here. We do have a USB-C for charging. On the bottom, we do have a headphone port, plus a little adapter thing here. And yeah, so you have your D-pad. You have your buttons here in the nice clear. Really, really nice. You have your touchpad up on top that it clicks. And then you have a light button, which is a syncing button probably, and then a menu button. So just overall feel, I love the feel of this. The triggers actually feel very, very nice. You can kind of hear the R1 and L1 have a bit of a click to them. The R2, L2 have a bit of a click at the end, but not as pronounced as the L1, R1. And Yeah, if you actually hit the controller, you can feel the haptic, whatever it is with the haptic engine on the inside. I don't know if it's like vibrations and everything, but you can actually feel it kind of vibrating all over the controller whenever you hit it. So that's going to be something interesting to see with the types of games that come out for the PlayStation 5. I love the two-tone design. You know, I'm a sucker for just all black. Like, I would have loved this controller if it was all black, to be honest. And that's why I think I love the Xbox controller. But this one being the two-tone color with sort of like that gray and clear, like, buttons right here, the signature, you know, triangle, square, X and circle, like, that's absolutely amazing. Like, it just looks super, super cool. That's my main impression. Let's see. So we just powered it on and you can kind of see there's little blue, there was like a blue ring on there. Let me see if I can turn that on and show it to you again. Yep, there you go. So there's a blue ring right over the touchpad, ready to sync the controller. And yeah, so this is retailing for about, I want to say $70, if I'm not mistaken. I did pre-order this. I'm not exactly sure how much it was. I kind of just went and pre-ordered it. There will be a controller inside the PlayStation 5 if you do purchase one, but I went ahead and purchased another because I am going to be using the PlayStation 5 in the living room to play games with my girlfriend. So had to get a second controller so we can enjoy some games together. But overall, the first impressions is I can definitely see myself, you know, playing a lot of shooters, adventure games and everything. And that's something that really held me back with the older PlayStations is I just never was comfortable with that controller. Playing shooters like Call of Duty, I never really enjoyed. The controllers just felt super, super small in my hand. And it was a little bit uncomfortable, especially with the joysticks and their position and, you know, the arms being a little bit shorter on the other DualShocks. So this is something that's very familiar when it comes to the Xbox controller. And just to show you for comparison, I'm actually going to bring this bad boy out. This is my Elite 2 controller. So this is the Elite 2. So the actual arms are a bit longer than the Xbox and you can kind of see it there. So this part actually comes down a little bit more compared to the Elite. And I think I like that. It's all because of the paddles that I like this being smaller, but without the paddles, it does feel weird. I don't know, the Xbox controller, this Elite controller just feels fantastic, by the way. But this one is a nice close second. Like I said, for PlayStation, this has to be my favorite controller yet. And I'm really excited to see the technology that's in here and how they incorporated it with the PS5. This really makes it feel next gen for me personally, because the new Xbox controller is pretty much the same as the Xbox One with some probably 4 to 5 changes to it. But this, they've gone, you know, Sony has gone pretty much crazy with the design of this. And, you know, I'm really excited to see what the future has for this controller, all its technologies on the inside. But there you have it, guys. It is available now. Like I said, check your local retailers. They might be available online. It cost about $69.99, if I'm not mistaken. I'll actually have the price up and I have it up on the screen. But yeah, let me know if you guys went ahead and picked up any of the accessories. Did you pick up a controller, the media remote, the Pulse headphones? And yeah, stay tuned for more Xbox Series videos as well as PlayStation 5. We're going to be unboxing the PlayStation 5 as well as the Series X later on in the channel. So I hope you guys like this video and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one.